Hello friends. Welcome to my video. In this video, I show you how to set up IP failover on Zabbix network monitoring with Keep Alived. Keep Alived is used for IP failover between two servers. Its facilities for load balancing and high availability to Linux-based infrastructures. It worked on virtual router redundancy protocol. In this video, we have configured IP failover between two Zabbix systems running as a high availability infrastructures. I have two Zabbix servers with IP addresses of 10.11.32.95 and 10.11.32.96, respectively. The goal of this video is to configure the virtual IP address for two Zabbix servers as 10.11.32.100. Let's move to the configuration IP failover setup between Zabbix 01 and Zabbix 02 servers. Let's move to the configuration IP failover setup between Zabbix 01 and Zabbix 02 servers. First of all, use the following command to install required packages to configure Keep Alived on the server. Keep Alived packages are available under default apt repositories. So just use a command to install it on both servers. Now create or edit Keep Alived configuration file on Zabbix 01 and add the following settings. Update all values with your network and system configuration. On your primary server, create the main Keep Alived configuration file. Virtual router ID should be same on both Zabbix 01 and Zabbix 02 servers. We also set up some simple authentication for our Keep Alive daemons to communicate with one another. Then open a block called VRRP instance, which is the main configuration section that defines the way that Keep Alive will implement high availability. Then assign an ID for this cluster group that will be shared by both nodes. After that, we will tell Keep Alive to use the routine we created at the top of the file, label check colived, to determine the health of the local system. Priority value will be higher on master server, it doesn't matter what you used in state. If your state is master but your priority is lower than the router with backup, you will lose the master state. Start Keep Alive service using the following command and also configure to auto start on system boot. Use the following command to show assigned virtual IP on the interface. Now save the primary server's configuration and move to the secondary server's configurations file setup. The most of the configurations will be similar to our primary server's configurations file. Note, the virtual IP address is the same, the password is the same on both servers. Priority value will be higher on master server, it doesn't matter what you used in state. Save the configuration file after making required changes and move to the next step. Use the following command to show assigned virtual IP on the interface. Next, you configure SNMP on both servers to monitor their health. Shut down master server and check if IPs are automatically assigned to slave server. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Now start Zabbix 01. IPs will automatically assign to master server.